Hello everyone, Iris France here. Today we're going to talk about price elasticity of demand and total revenue. Total revenue is equal to price times quantity. Due to the law of demand, when we raise the price, quantity demanded drops. As price and quantity demanded are moving in the opposite directions, what happens to the total revenue? The answer lies in price elasticity of demand. We will start with an elastic demand. We know that when the demand is elastic, the percentage change in quantity demanded is greater than the percentage change in price. Therefore, when price drops, quantity demanded will go way up. Here, I want you to draw a downward pointing arrow to indicate that the price drops. Then, draw a very large and thick arrow pointing upwards for quantity demanded. Then, your total revenue will be dominated by the larger arrow pointing up, so your total revenue will go up. Your original revenue is P1Q1, the yellow rectangle. Your new revenue is P2Q2, the purple rectangle. When the price drops, you will lose a little revenue from the lower price. However, you will gain more revenue from the bigger quantity. Hence, your total revenue goes up. In the exam, don't always bother to draw a diagram of demand and supply curves. Instead, just draw the arrows and compare their sizes. Then, tell yourself that the larger arrow will dominate the direction of total revenue. In this case, the quantity demand goes up and total revenue rises. What happens if the demand is elastic and the price rises? If demand is elastic, that means the percentage change in quantity demanded is greater than the percentage change in price in the magnitude. Therefore, draw an upward pointing arrow to indicate the price rises. Then, draw a thick downward pointing arrow to indicate that the quantity demanded drops by a lot. As such, total revenue will be dominated by the thick arrow and go down. The original total revenue is P1Q1, the blue rectangle, and the new total revenue is P2Q2, the green rectangle. Although there will be a little gain from the higher price, the gain is overshadowed by the revenue loss from a smaller quantity. As a result, total revenue goes down. Let's move on to inelastic demand. If the demand is inelastic, that means the change in quantity demanded is not responsive to a change in price. If the price goes up, quantity demanded drops by tiny a little bit. So, we will draw an arrow pointing up beside the price to indicate a rising price. Then, we will draw a tiny arrow pointing down beside the quantity to indicate that the quantity demanded drops by only a little bit. As a result, total revenue will be dominated by the larger upward pointing arrow, so the total revenue will rise. When the price goes up from P1 to P2, total revenue will go up from P1Q1, the blue rectangle, to P2Q2, the green rectangle. The company will lose a little revenue from a lower quantity demanded, but it will gain way more revenue by a higher price. Therefore, total revenue goes up. This is the reason why pharmaceutical companies often raise the price of their drugs. If you need medication to survive, how much medication are you going to cut when you face a higher price? If the demand is inelastic and the price goes down, then quantity demand will increase tiny a little bit. Draw a downward pointing arrow beside the price to indicate the price drop. And draw a tiny upward pointing arrow beside the quantity to show the tiny increase in quantity demanded. As a result, the total revenue will be dominated by the relatively larger arrow, the drop in price in this case. Therefore, the total revenue will go down. Here, the initial revenue is equal to P1Q1, the yellow rectangle. The new revenue is equal to P2Q2, the purple rectangle. As price drops, the revenue will increase a little bit from a higher quantity. At the same time, we lose even more revenue from the price drop. Therefore, the total revenue goes down. Let's move on to unit elastic demand. When the demand is unit elastic, that means the percentage change in quantity demanded is the same as percentage change in price. When price goes up, quantity demanded drops in about the same magnitude. Therefore, total revenue remains the same. I suggest that you draw an upward-pointing arrow to indicate the increased price. Draw a downward-pointing arrow about the same size to indicate the decreased quantity. As the arrows are about the same size, neither dominates. As a result, the total revenue remains the same. Here, P1Q1, the blue rectangle, is the initial revenue, and P2Q2, the green rectangle, is the new revenue. We gain some additional revenue from a higher price, and we lose some revenue from a lower quantity. The gain and the loss are about the same size, so total revenue does not change. When the demand is unielastic and the price drops, then the quantity demanded rises about the same magnitude. Therefore, total revenue remains the same. Again, I suggest that you draw a downward-pointing arrow to indicate the decreased price. Draw an upward-pointing arrow about the same size to indicate the increased quantity. As the arrows are about the same size, neither dominates, and as a result, total revenue remains the same. The original revenue is P1Q1, the yellow rectangle, and the new revenue is P2Q2, the purple rectangle. As you can see, after the price drops, the revenue gain from a higher quantity is the same as the revenue loss from a lower price. Therefore, total revenue remains the same. There is no need to memorize any of the lectures above. Use your arrow method. Draw in large and small arrows to determine whether your total revenue should go up, down, or remains the same when the price changes. In summary, if your demand is elastic, then quantity demanded is very responsive to a changing price. If the price goes up, quantity demanded will go way down, draw a large arrow, and total revenue will drop. Remember, the bigger arrow dominates the direction of total revenue. If price drops, then quantity demanded will go way up, and the total revenue will also rise. If the demand is inelastic, then quantity demanded is not too responsive to a changing price. If the price goes up, quantity demanded will drop by tiny a little bit, draw a tiny arrow, and total revenue will rise. Remember, the bigger arrow dominates the direction of total revenue. If the price drops, then the quantity demanded will go up by just tiny a little bit. As a result, the total revenue will drop. Finally, if the demand is unielastic, then the percentage change in price and the percentage change in quantity demanded are the same, so neither dominates. Therefore, the total revenue remains the same whether the price rises or drops. This concludes price elasticity of demand and total revenue. I hope the arrow method helps, and I'll see you next time.